Welcome back to No Man's Sky, everyone. Jason here, and the update is out. And we know officially that the update is called Expeditions. Holy cow, it is update 3.3. But let's jump into the details, because holy cow, there's a lot to this update. It is insane. So at 7:01 a.m. my time, so I believe that's like 1 o'clock UK time. Correct me if I'm wrong down in those comments. Sean Murray just tweeted, No Man's Sky Expeditions. We have Galactic Expeditions, Mission Patches, New HUD and 4K UI, Expedition Planner, Visor Tech, Cross Save Rewards, Sentinel Balance, Performance Load and Optimized, Cross Platform Naming has been merged, Improved Pinning, Ongoing Seasons, it's free and out now. So, those are the bullet points, but we need to get into those details. So if you go over to nomansky.com, he has a whole bunch of stuff. So let's jump into those details, those notes. So, of course, the intro. Expeditions introducing update 3.3. Update 3.3, Expeditions introduces a brand new way to play No Man's Sky. Start a fresh journey in a brand new game mode. Master a unique set of challenges with revitalized mission mechanics, earn exclusive rewards, visit bustling hub worlds, and much, much more. So this is a whole new mode, like from the start menu. You can choose normal mode, you can choose creative, you can choose survival and permadeath, and now we have expedition mode, which is awesome. Okay, so keep going down, all right. Shared Expeditions, introducing a whole new game mode, Expeditions. Each of these events starts from a fixed point in the universe. Bring the whole community of travelers together to embark on a shared journey. Each expedition is structured around a series of milestones. Complete these unique exploration goals in any order as you earn rewards, meet up with fellow travelers, and experiment with new ways of playing No Man's Sky. So this seems like it's a permanently multiplayer turned on kind of deal, which is crazy. So you will actually, it'll start everyone at the same spot on the same planet, and we all are going through and completing different missions and different tasks. That is crazy. All right, then we have milestones and phases. Each expedition phase is made up of milestones. These challenges, ranging from the simple to the highly challenging, can be completed in any order. Milestones are open-ended, and each one is a chance to explore a different aspect of No Man's Sky. Every completed milestone brings a reward to assist you in your journey. Pin a milestone to your missions log to learn more. So they actually have almost like a multiplayer missions where you could just get in there, and you don't even have to do them in a certain order. You can do them in any order you want, it sounds like. Oh, I can't wait to try this out, you guys. Holy cow! That is crazy. So, and you get rewards for completing these different missions, or milestones, I should call them. Every full completed phase will unlock a unique reward, exclusive to those who undertake the expedition. An extra reward awaits those who complete the entire expedition. So I wonder how long this is going to last, because they're calling it an expedition. And later on, you'll see it's called Seasons. And so we're going to have different seasons. I wonder how long do they last? Are they going to be like a 1 month thing? Like a 6 month thing? I don't know. I can't wait to dig into that and see what's going on with that. Okay, then we go Space Station Missions Overhaul. Missions available from the Space Station Mission Agent have been completely reworked for greater depth and interest. Rewards have also been rebalanced, especially for higher level missions. So, I don't know if you guys use the mission envoy on the space station, but it was there before the whole Nexus and the space anomaly missions. You know, the big cube that you get missions from in the space anomaly. Well, they were giving out, the mission envoy was giving them out way before that, but they were kind of bare bones. Like, hey, go here and kill 5 sentinels, or go here and collect, you know, this plant, or go here and take a picture. And so they were kind of boring, and really wasn't, you know, it wasn't really compelling. So now they have a whole overhaul, and they've been rebalanced. So I can't wait to see what's going on with that. That's crazy. All right, milestone patches. Each completed expedition milestone reveals one of over 100 handcrafted patches. Reveal them all to fill out your album of accomplishments. So now we have patches. that you get only through the expedition mode. So I wonder if you can display those on your name badge, because I know you guys, we can customize our name badge. I wonder if we can actually put on a patch now that we have them, if you've unlocked them. Oh, I can't wait to get a whole bunch of patches too. Oh my God. All right. Mission target sweeping. The process of finding mission locations has been reworked to add a more exploration gameplay. Instead of just following a marker, the analysis visor has a new target sweep mode that requires players to use their tracking skills to precisely locate their target. That is really interesting, because before it would just say, hey, look, there's a mission, go to this exact spot, we mark it on your HUD, and you're good to go. Go here, pick up this plant or whatever. Now they won't even tell you exactly where it is. They just say, hey, hit this planet and then use your visor, the sweeping mode, to find out exactly where it is. That is crazy. Oh, and look at this. This is now, oh man. Okay, I guess Sean Murray is trying to tell me something, because Twitch drops. You can now earn in-game rewards by watching No Man's Sky on Twitch. The first official Twitch drop campaign will run from April 1st to April 5th and includes rewards such as character customizations, emotes, base parts, and ship decorations, and unique ships and multi-tools. Learn more and sign up at twitch.nomansky.com. So now you'll be able to actually get unique items from Twitch drops. Now, I'm hoping that they're not too unique, because I'm not on Twitch yet. So Sean, I have to set up all my stuff. I haven't done that yet, man. So I'm mostly on YouTube. So we'll get in there. I'll look into it and see what's going on with that. All right, weekend events are back. Yes, so look at this. Weekend events. New weekend missions are available from the Nexus. Each weekend, Polo and Nada will indicate a specifically located mission for all travelers to participate in and earn generous Quicksilver rewards. So we finally got our Quicksilver missions back from the weekend. Because I don't know if you guys, I'm hoping, number one, if you guys have played the Quicksilver missions before, you know that there's a storyline attached to that. Hopefully they're continuing that. But they are back, and I wonder how they're going to implement them. Like, are they going to be part of the expeditions, or are they going to be just, standalone like they used to be? I don't know. But I can't wait to find out, and hopefully they start this weekend. I can't wait. All right, and we had rendezvous points. Special rendezvous planets along with expedition routes create dynamic hubs of activity. Reunite with other travelers on the same journey. Group up with the community to build a settlement, or simply wave hello as you pass through. So is it actually going to be certain missions or different tasks you have to do that brings everyone together? That way we're all on the same planets, So that's basically like a weekend mission, because that's what the weekend mission was before. It was, hey, look, everyone has to go to this one planet and we have to do a certain task. Now that's going to be part of the expeditions. That is really cool. I like that. And then we have, Explorer Starship enhancements. The Explorer class starships have been visually refurbished with enhanced model and texture details. Wait a minute. They're only specifically updating the Explorer? I wonder why that is, because that is crazy that they're only updating one ship type. Now, I thought that they were going to update all the ship types, because we've had the same ship types for a while. So I thought, okay, they're going to update and revamp some of them. But they're only doing it for the Explorer. I wonder why the Explorer gets special attention. All right. Oh, and then we have frequent and ongoing expeditions. New expeditions will begin regularly. The duration and length of each expedition will be unique, as each will explore a different theme with bespoke challenges and new exclusive rewards. So, and I've seen that one of the rewards is a golden ship. You get a golden ship. Okay, so let's keep going. Each expedition begins fresh with a randomized character and set of technologies, recapturing the excitement of setting out into the universe for the very first time. Oh my God. And then undertake a time-limited expedition for special rewards. Okay. At the end of the expedition, the associated milestone and rewards will no longer be earned. However, your save game will still be available and will be converted to a normal mode save. Okay, so once you complete an expedition, it turns into a normal mode save? Wait a minute. So I'm a little bit confused. I thought we had just an expedition save. So if it turns into a normal mode save, Can I use my normal mode save to go into an expedition? Because I want to collect all of the... I want to collect all of the rewards. I wonder if you could share rewards between different saves, maybe? Like, maybe it's locked to your specific profile? Oh, man, there's so much going on here. I don't even know. Holy cow. All right. And then we have resource target sweeping. Target sweep can find more than just mission locations. Utilize this new mode to assist in locating rare resources, such as a sac venom or ancient bones, for pinned recipes as well as for mission objectives. So actually, the whole sweepy mode is not just for, it's not just for the expedition mode. It's for anything now. Holy cow, I wonder if they still mark it like they used to, because before, they would mark bones, like buried bones and different, you know, rare resources. They would mark it on your HUD automatically. I wonder if they, now you have to use a sweep mode to even find it. Oh, I can't wait. Oh, I can't wait. All right. Then we have a new mission board. The mission agent board has been visually revamped, improving the aesthetics and clarity of the information. Oh, okay. Actually, it does. It looks really almost like similar to the Nexus, the big cube mission board. That's actually pretty cool looking. It's more crisp and more clean. I like that. That looks really, really good. Now, I wonder if they are going to do a different, like, mission giver, like a mission guild. The mission agent, I should say. Huh. Oh, and then we have Sentinel Combat Enhancements. Sentinel Combat has been rebalanced to make combat more dynamic and satisfying, and to add an extra degree of challenge for players with an exceptional multi-tool loadout. I think he's talking to me specifically on that, because holy cow, they haven't been really, really hard. Not for a while, anyway. Sentinel quads have improved mobility and target locking. Sentinel drones display an icon while performing repairs to other sentinels, and sentinel walkers are now deployed to the planet via atmospheric ejection. So now the walkers will fall, they will Titan fall in, just like the exomech used to. The exomech did. Holy cow. So, yeah, that is actually really cool. And now they've officially recognized that Sentinel, flying Sentinels will actually repair different Sentinels, because they used to do it to only, walkers, but I guess now they'll repair the quads and everything else. Wow. That is really cool. All right, then we have quality of life. A number of quality of life improvements have been introduced, including the ability to use the quick menu to switch their primary starship while docked at the space anomaly. So now you can just switch it while it's parked. I love it. The pinning system has been significantly improved to provide more accurate and helpful guidance while crafting products or installing and repairing technologies. A number of recipe costs have been rebalanced to reduce grind gameplay, and terrain resource deposits now yield a more generous supply of materials. So I don't know if you guys remember, but I for a long time, and you guys probably hated me for it, but I used to always tell everyone constantly that when you're using the terrain manipulator to mine a resource, you can choose the size of the terrain manipulator, the mining beam, because if you got a bigger mining beam, it would give you less resources, but it would be really fast. So if you had to do something really quick, you use the big mining beam. If you use the smaller one, terrain manipulator beam. If you use the smaller one, it would take a long time, but it would give you the most resources. So I wonder if they're changing that now. Holy cow. Oh, and then we have cross-platform discoveries. The discoveries database has been made cross-platform. So your discoveries, planets, star systems, alien fauna, and more are now shared between all players on all platforms. Community mission progress is now pooled between all platforms. So yeah, we only have one progress now, bringing the whole community together to unlock new Quicksilver items. So now, because before it was, hey, look, if you're on PlayStation, you have your own cross, you know, you have your own progress. And if you're on Xbox, you have your own progress. And if you're on PC, you had your own progress. Now they're all tied together. I like it. Uploaded bases, including featured bases, can now be visited on any platform, making cross-platform play with friends more seamless than ever. So now if you're a featured bases, if you're uploaded, you can actually visit because everyone's sharing everything. Holy cow. Oh, I cannot wait to jump in and see, because there's all these, you know, awesome bases that are like on on PlayStation. Like, I know Captain Steve, he builds on PlayStation 4 and 5 now. And so I would never be able to play with him because I was on Xbox or PC. But now I can go visit his stuff. Oh, I can't wait. I can't wait to see that. It's going to be so amazing. Oh, and then we have a new HUD. The in-game HUD has been completely refreshed for a cleaner and more legible appearance. And so now, I can't wait to jump in there because they always give you these cool pictures, but it's always different. Like, when you see it for yourself, you could say, whoa. It's like watching, you know, a TV, and you're like, okay, when I watch a really good TV on my kind of crummy TV, it looks better, but I don't know how good it looks until you see it in person. So I can't wait to see that. Performance and loading optimizations. A significant number of performance and loading load optimizations have been introduced across all platforms, reducing initial load and warp times, improving texture loading and terrain regeneration speed, and removing some physics-related stalls that occurred. And so, yeah, I remember specifically when they introduced the Origins update, and I was playing on PC, and if you use your jetpack shoulder boost enough, you can actually go faster than the terrain can load. Well, that used to be the case. I'm going to have to try that out and see if we could actually, you know, if they can load the terrain faster than I can shoulder boost. I don't know. It doesn't say that specifically, but I'm hoping that's the case. Exclusive new rewards. Progressing through the expedition phases will unlock exclusive rewards. Among the Pioneer's expedition rewards are a golden starship and helmet, a new lightweight jetpack unit, Atlas fireworks, elaborate gold fringed flag, and more. Holy cow, Atlas fireworks? What does an Atlas firework mean? What is that? Because we had fireworks before, but they were separate colors. Like, you could get green, blue, and red. Now we have exclusive Atlas fireworks? Oh, I can't wait to get those and fire them off. And hopefully, they're not like usable, meaning like you had to buy every single firework. If you bought one and you used it, it was gone. You had to go buy another one. Holy cow. Oh, there is a golden Gek helmet. Oh, I can't wait, you guys. Holy cow. And then we have new markers. All markers for missions, buildings, and resources have been restyled for greater clarity, definition, and visual appearance. Holy cow. Okay, so now we're going to be able to actually see new... Oh, I can't wait. Look at those different icons. So it's going to be such a... It's like a brand new game almost, you guys. This is craziness. Then we have cross-save rewards. Rewards earned from expeditions can be redeemed for free on other saves. Okay, there you go. That's they solved it. For free on other saves in any game mode by visiting the Quicksilver Synthesis Companion on the Space Anomaly. Transfer your hard-earned golden vector to your primary save. That's how they got around it. I was so afraid that I was going to have it locked to one save, and I wanted to keep that save and just keep using it. But it looks like once you've unlocked it, it's to your profile. So whatever profile you're playing on, like if you're on PS5 or Xbox Series X or whatever, you're on PlayStation or Xbox or PC, once you've unlocked that save, or once you've unlocked that item, it's connected to your profile, which is amazing. So you don't even have to worry about going and getting it again. Oh, I can't wait. Streamlined jetpack unit. Look at this jetpack. It looks like an old school. Oh, I can't wait. Included among the expedition rewards is the streamlined jetpack unit, featuring an elegant single thruster design and transforming the appearance of your explorer. Once earned, equip your new jetpack at any appearance modifier. Look at this jetpack. It looks like something from the Rocketeer. Holy cow. That is amazing. That, I can't wait. Now, they're outlining all of this stuff. Is this stuff, I hope we can get this like right off the bat. Like, hopefully we can unlock this. I mean, not right off the bat, but hopefully we don't have to wait like, you know, because usually with the Quicksilver Merchant, it would only unlock, you know, a couple different things every week. And so you'd have to wait like a month before you got to the good stuff. Holy cow! Multiplayer mission improvements. The multiplayer missions available from the Nexus on the Space Anomaly have been enhanced with a number of gameplay improvements. Numerous bugs and synchronization issues have been fixed, and missions have been made smoother and more exciting by incorporating target sweeps to locate resources. So hopefully, with all that being, you know, all that being said, hopefully that means we can actually get in and play multiplayer cross-platform, because before it felt like it would work sometimes, but not always. And so I'm hoping that they've updated it to where we can invite, like I play on PC, but I can invite someone else in from a different platform and you're good to go. Golden Vector, explorers who fully complete the inaugural expedition, pioneers, will be able to claim the Golden Vector Starship, an opulent gold edition of the classic Alpha Vector. Oh, so you have to do this first one. And from everything I've seen and read so far, it sounds like the first expedition is going to run for 1 week. So you got to get in there real fast and start doing that now. And you'll get the Golden Vector. Oh my God, I'm so excited, guys. I am so pumped up for this update. And then they have all the patch notes in. Holy cow. There is a lot of patch notes. So I would say go over to nomansky.com. Look at all of it. Holy, I'm just scrolling through the list now. If you thought the Cyberpunk update had a lot of notes, jeez, there's a lot of notes on this. All right, this is a huge video. I'm super pumped up. Are you guys pumped up? Hit the like button and jump into No Man's Sky. I'm probably going to have to do a live stream or something because there's a lot of stuff here. And I'm going to see you guys in the game, definitely. So, see you next time.